No. Oh, wait a minute. Isn't she the daughter or the niece?
Niece.
Niece of Owen Bancroft?
That's right. He was a writer.
Yes. He died about 6 weeks ago.
That's right. Up in Scarsville, New York.
That's right. Well, what about Honoria Bancroft?
Well, she wants an agent to handle her uncle's works. He wrote detective stories, didn't he?
No, not detective stories. Horror stories and ghost stories, the best I've ever read. He made Dracula look like Miss America. If you could get a hold of those stories, you'd make a fortune.
I don't know. This letter is so strange.
Why?
Well, she's been approached by several agents to handle the stuff, but none of them was right. And she wants me to come up to her house in Scarsville tonight.
Her house? Oh, it's a fantastic house. It's haunted, you know.
Haunted?
Yes. A family named Dubois was bludgeoned to death there in 1837. They're supposed to haunt it now.
Well, I'm not going.
Well, now, don't tell me you're afraid of ghosts.
Don't be ridiculous. Of course I'm not afraid of ghosts.
Yes, you are. I can see it in your face.
Well, if you can see it in my face, you're reading between the lines. Reading between the lines of my face. Get it?
Yes, but I don't know what to do with it. Well, Mr. Sands, if you're not going up there, why don't you let me go? I'm a great fan of Bancroft's, and I'm not afraid of ghosts, and I can talk to his niece and know what I'm talking about. I'll never forget screaming the night. Let me tell you about it. This woman, Marietta, who's the heroine, arrives at this house late at night. She goes up to the door and rings the bell. No answer. She rings the bell again. No answer. And just as she's about to knock, the door opens slowly, all by itself. She goes through the door and into the drawing room. And then she hears this scream from somewhere. And all of a sudden, this woman appears out of thin air, all dressed in black.
Oh, Susie, that's enough.
Oh, but I'll never forget the part where she's in bed. And this panel behind her, see? And it opens up. And all of a sudden, this hand appears. And it clutches at her throat. And she's free!
Oh, Susie, really?
Blood-curdling, isn't it?
Evening.
Oh, hello. I didn't hear you come in.
I move silent. I'm Honoria Bancroft.
And I'm Susan McNamara.
Of course. I'm expecting another literary representative.
Oh, I wonder if I know who it is.
Mr. Mickey Calhoun. Do you know him?
Mickey Calhoun. Yes, I know him.
He should be in a moment. I believe I heard him wandering about the grounds. And now tell me, Miss McNamara, have you read many of my uncle's books?
Oh, yes, I have many of them. As a matter of fact, aren't these some of the stories here? I particularly like this one. I wonder how long I've been talking to myself.
Thank you.
glasses on, lover boy. It's me.
Who me? Foxy McNamara.
K.G. Calhoun.
What are you doing here?
Well, I might ask the same of you. They told me this place was haunted, but they didn't tell me it was contaminated.
2 cents, I'd scram this joint. It's full of creeps.
Well, it takes one to know one.
Would you like me to show you to the door?
Yeah. Oh, no. Not so fast. Nobody's going to say that Foxy McNamara stuck around and K.G. Calhoun didn't.
But you just told me you were afraid.
Yeah, how come you're so cool about all this? Why ain't you scared?
Well, I'm a big girl now.
That's so. I got news for you. I'm a big boy. I ain't scared neither.
Good evening.
Foxy! What was that?
I'm Honoria Bancroft.
And this is Mr. Calhoun.
We didn't hear you come in.
I move quietly.
Yes, I'll say.
Well, I'm certainly pleased to see you, Miss Bancroft.
Did you have trouble finding the house?
Oh, no, your directions were very explicit. A quarter of a mile past the cemetery.
It was nothing.
Please sit down.
Thank you.
Oh, no, not there, Mr. Calhoun. That's Uncle Owen's chair.
Do you think he'd mind?
Certainly. He's sitting in it. Please sit down. And now, Miss McNamara, Mr. Calhoun, you are not the first literary representatives.
Please call us agent, Miss Bancroft.
Please call me Bancroft, Mr. Calhoun.
Oh, excuse me.
You are not the first literary agents to be interested in my uncle's works. I trust that both of you are familiar with his books.
Oh, yes, I've read all of them. As a matter of fact, a couple of them, two or three times.
Me too. I had a regular prescription.
Splendid. We shall see. I believe Uncle Owen's books to be classics in their field. He adored his work, and so do I. Some rather unscrupulous agents came here pretending to be familiar with Uncle's works, but I soon found them out.
Miss Bancroft, I don't know what certain other agents can offer you, but I assure you, once you hear my deal, you'll be obliged to look no further. I would like to convert with you in privacy.
We're all friends here.
Oh.
Would you like me to leave?
If you don't mind, Susie, Miss Bancroft and I would like to be alone.
What makes you think we'd be alone if Miss McNamara left?
Yeah.
Shall I go?
Don't move.
Come along, I'll show you to your rooms.
To our rooms?
Oh, well, thank you very much, but we really didn't come prepared to spend the night.
You'll find everything you need in your room.
But we
could go to a hotel.
Don't you like my house, Mr. Calhoun?
Oh, sure, I love it.
It's an imposition.
Yeah, that's right, we wouldn't want to put you out.
No one is putting me out, I can assure you.
That's very kind.
Not at all.
Well, I don't know.
Well, why don't you go to a hotel, K.G.?
That's a good idea, I think. No. Foxy, as long as you're going to stay, so am I.
Then that's settled.
When can we talk?
Tomorrow.
Will I be here tomorrow?
You probably need these.
Don't you have any electricity here?
Certainly. The front gate is electrified. I've put you here, Miss McNamara.
Oh, it's lovely.
Can I get you anything?
No, thank you. I'll be quite all right.
Then good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night, Katie.
Good night, Foxy. If I shouldn't happen to see you again.
This way, Mr. Calhoun. This is your room, Mr. Calhoun.
It's quite cozy. Oh, what a layout you have here. How many rooms do you have in this joint, this establishment?
27.
27? Wow. And you live here alone?
Oh, no. The house is full.
Well, I'm sure glad to hear that.
I didn't mean people.
That's different. Hello, operator. I want to speak to Mr. Ben Moss in New York City. Please. Yes, the number here is Scarsville O. Listen, Ben, I got troubles. Plenty of troubles. Yeah, I gotta stay here overnight, and as if there ain't enough spooks up here, who do you think I bumped into? Foxy McNamara. I tell you, I never should have come here. This place is like the Wax Museum at Coney Island. Yeah, only here they ain't kidding. Kid, I'm trembling. Look at my hand. I'm going to pieces, I tell you. You ought to see this bankrupt dame. Boy, when she dies, how will they know? Benny, is that you going ooh? No, I'm not going ooh. But then who's going ooh? But Benny, I tell you, I'm scared stiff. Benny, my bosom pal, listen to me. You know where my will is? Yeah, under the mattress. You better get it out.
I don't think I'll be around this way again.
But Benny, I gotta go now, Benny. Somebody's at the door. Yeah, I hope it's somebody. I'll see you later. Come in.
I just wanted to make sure you're all right, Mr. Calhoun.
Oh, yeah, sure. Everything is just grand. Peachy. As a matter of fact, I was just going to bed. Good night.
I hope you don't mind sharing the room.
What do you mean? Sharing the room?
This is Uncle Owen's room. But as you see, it's a large bed. But Uncle Owen sleeps on the right. Good night, Mr. Calhoun. So that's it.